आई रिमेम्बर द टॉपिक विच वी वॉज गोइंग ऑन द ओके दैट डे आई वॉज एक्सप्लेनिंग यू दैट वॉट इज तमिल इलम इलम मीन्स ए स्टेट सो ऑल द थ्री डिमांड फोर डिमांड्स वर देयर ऑफ श्रीलंकन्स दे वॉन्टेड देयर तमिल लैंग्वेज एज टू बी ऑफिशियल लैंग्वेज they wanted regional autonomy I explained the meaning of regional autonomy that means they wanted to have their own government in the area where they live then the next demand was that they must get equal opportunity in the university seats and the government job then in 1980 they started demanding that The areas where they live, actually they are living in the eastern coastal area, northern coastal area, those areas should be made as a state, Tamil state, okay? So they wanted Tamil state there. So these four demands they started and which were not liked by the Sinhala peoples. Now go to the next column so you can see that next column. The distress between the two communities turned into widespread conflict and it soon turned into a civil war. So you must know the meaning of civil war. Okay, the civil war means between two communities in the same country the people fight. It can be just like a war, how the India-Pakistan war is there, that is between two countries, but it is within a own country the two communities they fight. So the distress the good relation between Sri Lankan people Sri Lankan Tamils and Sinhala it was strained they were not having good relation and finally it became so bad that it turned into a civil war means they started killing each other they started looting each other and it was widespread in the country As a result, thousands of people of both the communities have been killed. Look at what is the now civil war. Because of the civil war, thousands of people of both communities have been killed. It's not that when war is there, the number of Sinhala, of course, they were more in number, but even their number was more, but the loss was there from both the sides. So The Tamils were also losing the life. Even Sinhala people also were losing life in the civil war. Now going to the next line, many families were forced to leave the country as refugees and many more lost their livelihoods. The first loss was that there was loss of life from both the sides. Then the second was that many people were forced to leave the country. Whenever there is civil war, unrest in the country, other people become panicked and they start leaving that country. Okay? And when you leave, you are only taking only your life with your all property, your places, whatever, your even work, your livelihood, occupation, everything is gone. So there was so much loss, the loss of people life. Then there was the people were forced to go away from the country as a refugee. Refugee means they went to another country, the nearest may be India. They came to India or Maldives. There are some more countries. So they became refugees in those countries. And they lost their livelihood, their occupation, they lost it. So no money with them. You have read of economics textbook class 10th, chapter 1 of economics in the class 10th about Sri Lanka's excellent record of economic development, education and health. Okay, you must have seen that there was economic development in the country Sri Lanka and there was development in the economic development, education wise, health wise, every place that it took it. But because of the civil war, there was a setback everything got disturbed nothing was now in the same place and it ended in 2009 actually there was a leader he was known by the name Prabhakaran he was Tamil leader okay he was from India but his forefathers settled there so he was born and brought up there he was leading this agitation and this agitation came to an end or the civil war came to an end by 2009 okay so whenever there is the moral of the story is that whenever there is any civil war, whenever there is any civil war, there will be so much loss. There can be human life loss, there can be economic loss, there can be the people can become refugees, they will move to the other countries, and many people will lose their livelihood. So I hope this much you have understood. Tell me, did you understand this much? Hello? Shall I move to the next now?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Okay, now moving to the next topic. Look at the heading of the next topic. What is the heading? Accommodation in Belgium. Now, accommodation. The meaning itself tells you, the word tells you that in Belgium, the Belgium government accommodated. Okay, they gave a place to all the communities. So, how they solved their problem of, there was also tension between Dutch and French. So, how they manage this tension to reduce, or how they have done the arrangement, that we are going to learn in this topic. Okay, so that is why the heading is given, accommodation in Belgium. Okay, now what accommodation they have done, that we are going to see. The Belgian leaders took a different path. Now, story of Sri Lanka, just now you have understood that there was a civil war. There was war between the two communities. There was loss of life between of the two communities. But Belgium people did not follow the path of Sri Lanka. They followed a different path. So what is that? They recognized the existence of regional differences and cultural diversities. Now, Belgium government, they agreed that they will accommodate the regional differences. The regional differences were there between French and Dutch. Even there were cultural differences between French and Dutch. So they agreed they are going to accommodate all these differences. Now, how they are going to accommodate? Between 1970 and 1993, they demanded their constitution. No. They amended their constitution 4 times so as to work out an arrangement that would enable everyone to live together within the same country. Actually, you get here. When there was tension, you know that the tension lasted for 10 years from 1950 to 1960, I think. Am I right? Look at the first paragraph there. It was given the year. It lasted for, yes. It start, yes, 1950s to 1960. 10 years there was tension, and still they took time. And by the year 1970 and 1993, between these years, from 1970 to 1993, they amended their constitution 4 times. So this question has come many times in the board examination. How many times Belgium amended the constitution from 1970 to 1993? So many students will not pay attention. So please do remember, they amended their constitution 4 times to accommodate all the regional diversities and cultural diversities of 3 communities, French, German and Dutch. Okay, so you have understood this much. Now moving to the next line. Look at that. Here are some of the elements of the Belgian model. Now, this model is actually power sharing model. Model means actually what method they followed it, that we are going to learn. Okay. Now, first point. This is very important. We are going to learn, I think there are four points are there. The Belgium model is very, very famous in the world. The power sharing model of Belgium, and how they solve the differences between the 3 communities by following this beautiful model. Now, what is this beautiful model? First point, okay? Constitution prescribes that the number of Dutch and the French speaking ministers shall be equal in the central government. Now, before going to this, you need to understand In Belgium, just like India, they have levels of government. In India, we have central government, we have state government, then we come for the local government. Local government, we have Gram Panchayat, municipal, corporation. Three levels are there in the local government. Okay, Gram Panchayat in the small village. When you go to the town, it is the municipal, and when you go to the big cities, it is corporation. But in Belgium, they have a different setup. They have central government, they have state government. Okay, now, and they have one more government which is known by the name community government. Okay, so put that picture in the mind, then you will understand these points. Now, first point tells you that constitution, that Belgium constitution, they changed four times. So, in that Belgium constitution, they made it, they have written it that number of Dutch ministers, number of French ministers in the central government will be same. If 20 is from Dutch, 20 will come from French. Okay, they have not seen their total strength that 59 is Dutch and 40% is French and 1% is German. No, they have taken that in the central government. And where will be the central government? Tell me. Where the central?
In Brussels.
Very good student. In Brussels, there is a central government which runs the entire country, and in the central government, the number of Dutch ministers and number of French ministers will be equal. That was the law made in the constitution. Okay, now moving to the next line. Some special laws require the support of majority of members from each linguistic group. Thus, no single community can make decision unilaterally. Okay, now it is given here. Some special laws require the support of majority of members from each linguistic group. There were the laws which are concerned or which we are going to affect the three communities. So such type of laws can be made only by the consent of the three communities. No single community can make law which is may affect the other community. So is it clear? In the central government, number of ministers will be same from French and Dutch, and special laws which are related to the these three communities cannot be made by a single community. That means the consent of the three communities is must. So I hope you have understood. Moving to the second point, second element of the model, many powers of the central government have been given to state governments of the two regions of the country. The state governments are not subordinate to the central government. Now, central government is powerful because it is running the entire country. Even many of the powers of the central government, it is also given to the state governments. Okay, you know there are only two states in Belgium. One is Wallonia, one is Flemish. So Wallonia and Flemish also got almost similar powers which the central government is having. So the states are not answerable to the central government. The state governments are not subordinate. Subordinate means they are not answerable. They also have the freedom of taking the decision making in their own states. That is the meaning here. Okay. Moving to the third point. Brussels has a separate government in which both the communities have equal representation. Brussels has a separate government. Now, I will tell you, you can understand with the help of the Indian example. Now, in the center, the Prime Minister is there, Narendra Modi. That is for the entire nation of our country, India. But Delhi is the capital. Do you know who is the Chief Minister of Delhi?
Arvind Kejriwal.
Very good. And Arvind Kejriwal is the Chief Minister of Delhi. Okay. So that means Delhi is having a separate government. Like how Maharashtra is having a separate government. Of course, Maharashtra is a big state. Delhi is a union territory. But it is having the separate government. Other union territories are not having the separate government. Okay. They are run by the central government. But Delhi is having the separate government. So same way, Brussels is also having a separate government. And good point is there that in Brussels also, the government where this government is there, there the number of Dutch and French is again same. This point you should keep in central government, the number of Dutch and French ministers are same, as well as the Brussels is having a separate government, there also the number of Dutch and French is same. Okay, so it's very easy to understand. Now moving to the next line, you look at here, the French speaking people, you know that in Brussels 80% are French, 20% are only Dutch, clear? Now, but this French people, though they were more in number in the Brussels city, but they accepted that they will have equal number of French and Dutch ministers in the Brussels government. That arrangement they accepted, okay? Because why they accepted? Because the Dutch accepted this equal number in the central government of French people. That's why. Okay, I will again conclude, then you will understand it. Now moving to the next fourth point. Now this fourth point is unique to Belgium. You will not find anywhere in any country this point, this model. Apart from the central government, look at here. There is central government, there is state government. State government is there, then Flemish in Wallonia. Central government is there at center. Brussels government is there for capital city. Okay. There is a third kind of government. Now, this third kind of government is known by the name community government, okay? So, now again understand, central government for the entire Belgium, state government for Wallonia and Flemish, both are having separate state governments. Brussels is also having separate government. Then they introduced one more type of government which is known by the name community government. Now this community government means a government made by three communities, Dutch, French and German. Actually now this community government doesn't exist in any country of the world. We can compare this community government with our local government, okay? We have local government, no, my dear? We have local government, that is Panchayat Municipal Corporation. So, in place of community government, we introduce in our country the local government, panchayat, municipal and corporation. But Belgium is having community government. Now, what this community government do? Let us see. This community government is elected by people belonging to one language community. The languages you know, Dutch, French and German speaking. No matter where they live. This government has the power. Now, this what they are going to do? They have the power regarding making laws for three things. Look at the three things which are given here. Cultural, educational and language related issues they will be looking after. So, this is the community government which is a special feature of your Belgium power model. So, they have a community government which is elected by the three communities. The members of the three communities will be there in the government and they will be looking after the areas, which areas? The cultural, educational and language related issues. They will be looking after these areas. Okay, now tell me, have you understood all the four points very nicely? Okay, or shall I repeat one time?
Yes, ma'am.
One time more, you want me to repeat it? Can any child tell me the four points in short? You can make the points short. Now look at the points once again, I will tell you. The first point, instead of writing a big point, you can make it short one. That in the first point I am telling you, explaining you again, that the constitution prescribes, that means it is written in the constitution, that Dutch and French ministers in the central government will be equal in number. And any law which are related to these three communities, cannot be passed by any one single community unilaterally. That means the consent of the three communities is must. Then only they can pass the that law which are related to these three communities, may be culture, may be religion, may be language, whatever it is. Okay. Now moving to the second point. The second point tells you that many powers of central government are also given to the state government. So state government and central government are equally powerful. There is no difference. But in India, it is not like that. In India, central government is powerful. State governments are not that powerful like the center. Clear? So you need to keep it in mind. In Belgium, central government and state government are equally powerful. So state government is not answerable. State government is not subordinate to central government. Okay? You know the meaning of subordinate. Principal is there and we are subordinate to principal. So same way, state is not subordinate to the central government. They are free. Okay. Now, moving to your third point. Third point tells you that Brussels is having a separate government. So look at here. There is a central government. Then there is a Flemish government. Then there is a Wallonia government. Then there is a Brussels capital city government, and in the capital city government, number of French people and number of Dutch people, they are equal. Ministers from both are taken, the number is equal. Though the population is French more, but they accepted that there will be equal numbers of French and Dutch people. So I hope you have understood this. Moving to your fourth point, the fourth point is a unique point which is only found in Belgium. No other country you will find this. Now here it is, that community government, apart from the central government, apart from the state government, even apart from the Brussels government, there is a next government, that is community government. And this community government members, the ministers are taken from all the three groups, Dutch, French and German. Clear? And they look after the matters which are related to culture, which are related to education, which are related to language of these four. So I hope now you have understood.